Howdy, it's me, Manic Mark, coming to you from the bunker system located underneath the Art Fellow found somewhere in the jungles of the Midwest. Damn it. They got me a beer out of the refrigerator, and now I don't remember where the hell I put it. Where's my damn beer? Oh, there it is. No, that's not it. That's WD-40.
What the hell?
There it is.
Jeez, me, Christmas.
It's easy to lose stuff down here. I almost lost my Bud Light Lime. I'm here today, once again, with Manic Mark Show, with my sidekick, Headless Tim, fully articulated, but Headless Tim. All right, what's going on today? Okay, I'm going to go ahead and the cool things at work. We got the first of all, the Carlisle and Finch amazing world-class Carlisle and Finch train layout donated this year. It's apparently world-class. All the other train guys are like, hey, this is world-class. This is pretty amazing. Just the whole collection of really rare stuff. Made in Cincinnati, which is why, which is cool for us to being a Cincinnati museum to feature it. Carlisle and Finch right there. And the second thing, due to some weirdness with the Lego show, which they can't call it the Lego show because they're calling it the Brick Show, because Legos doesn't have anything to do with it, except that's what the things are built on with is Legos. And anyway, this is a local Lego thing that had to be moved to our exhibit away from the other exhibit, which is fine. Is the amazing gigantic Lego layout featuring many Cincinnati landmarks made out of Legos, including just a lot of fun little weird things like superheroes and movie characters, and just I just really enjoy looking at it. So anyway, I've just finished up that deal, that gig. Today's video features, drink another one. Features a stack of records. Every now and then I've got two records from two sources today. I've got this stack of records here, this stack of records. Came from a very nice, a good-hearted person at work who was taking care of some of his parents' things, including the stack of records. What I like about opening stack of records off the cuff like this is that what was in their collection, what did they like to listen to, and that sort of thing. Okay, so it just goes beyond my collecting interest and becomes interesting in that respect. And then I've got another stack of records here that I picked up elsewhere to share with you today. Okay, so we're going to pull out. I could probably just tear this off with my bare hands, but I'd like to use the knife. I like to whip out the knife and just cut the bindings off. Shrink wrap. That's right. Cut the shrink wrap. I think I'm going to put this knife in fully articulated but headless Tim's pocket. He's holding Tony the Tiger today. So I put the knife in there, so if anybody ever comes in the house and down into the bunker to assault me, headless Tim can whip out the knife and protect me. I have to say, when I come down here to leave, I forget that he's down here, and I flip on a light, and I'm like, ah! For a moment, my heart's like, and then it goes away, and I'm back to normal. Okay. The first record on the stack is Gershwin, Rhapsody in Blue, Leonard Bernstein at the piano and conducting the Columbia Symphony Orchestra at American in Paris. Leonard Bernstein, conductor. Second on the list. The stack, not the list. It's Lawrence. Thank God it's Friday. It's Bubbles in the Wine. Bubbles in the Wine. It's champagne music, not wine music. This is pretty awesome. It's a copy of, Sumac. I'm going to have to give Chris a digital file of, I don't know if he's familiar with her, but she's effing, freaking, like a freak of nature, amazing. She's just one of my, I got a photograph of her autographed. You know, that's how crazy I am about Yama, which I'm probably mispronouncing, although I'm crazy about her. I probably can't pronounce her name correctly. This is one of her earlier, better, well, they're all good. I've collected almost all of her records. Anyway, good stuff. Really clean copy. Okay, it's a classical guitar player, Spanish, kind of. Anyway, it's early deca. That's probably from 1958, I would guess. 58 or 59, be my guess. That'll be interesting to listen to. Charles Capio, Miller Serenades, Hawaiian Paradise. Hawaiian record I do not have. From the Royal Hawaiian Hotel. Right there. Alright, that's cool. This is a album I actually do have. It's pretty cool though. Well, you know, I have it. I don't remember the sticker. Anyway, it's just an amazing, it's a cool thing to have in your collection because it's amazingly complex and expensive print job. I don't think I have this, the sleeve, that fancy sleeve. I don't have that. Where's the darn record? It's got to be in here. There it is. So the sleeve. Yeah, they don't have the sleeve, so I've got the sleeve. Anyway, it's like the only spiral bound record I've ever seen, all right, with pages on the inside, full color, super expensive jack in there. Anyway, that's cool. It's cool to collect for that reason. NK. Amazing Grace, the Pipes and Drums and Military Band and Regimental Band of Scotland. Now, you threw out those records, and then this was in the collection. This is what I'm saying. What are people like, oh, well, I bought the Hawaiian record, but I always wanted to listen to pipes and military band music, too. That's the interesting thing about, you know, why people collect what they collect. It's The Godfather. Paramount Pictures include the soundtrack, The Godfather, right there. Do I have this one? I'm not sure. It's not for the very young. It's Peter Pan. I don't think I've got this one. This is a spooky ghost record. I don't remember. Peter Pan, Ghost Sounds, if I've got that one. Hank Williams, it's a budget cornet, a tribute record to Hank Williams. It's not actually Hank singing, it's somebody else singing his songs. Don't have this one, that's a fun cover. That'll be interesting to listen to. I don't have this one. This is a super cover. Barclay Allen, Latin and American Piano Rhythms. Just a terrific cover. I'm not sure if I get Latin and American. So Latin and American. This. Thank you. almost Christmas. I'm wearing my Christmas vest. Because it's nearly Christmas. Okay. Judy and Garland are starving. I was just a little chilly. And I think I got some lunch on my shirt, so I was kind of trying to cover it. Never mind. Judy Garland, A Star Is Born. Oh, man. Okay. No, oh, man, me. That she has great legs. Judy, look at that. This is the cover where she has legs. I like that part. It's an hour of dance polkas. It's Plymouth. It's Plymouth. This is an incredible collection of records from all over, from the spectrum of record collecting. Dance polkas on Plymouth, which is the most budget, bargain budget basement label ever. Usually these are 10-inchers. So this is this full-sized 33rd full-sized. Okay. Ringling Brothers, and she go from military dance, Scottish bagpipe, to circus music. On Decca, circus music on Decca. And who hasn't found a copy of this now? It's again Palace, the Singing Nun. It's Palace is another super budget label, and I have to listen to it just because I want to know what their version of the Singing Nun is going to sound like. This is a nice cover from the Arthur Fiedler made like a million records, so it's not surprising that there would, it would be an Arthur Fiedler record in the stack of records. I haven't seen this cover. It's a nice painting. I like that one. Okay, and then Le Grand in Rio. I may have this record, and it's a good one. I may have it. It's a good one, and this will be a fine mini fresh copy, which I will test drive at some point. Okay, here we go. Connie Francis. There's a fine photograph. Connie Francis, right there on that album. Dean Martin, I Can't Give You Anything But Love. I haven't heard this one yet, okay. It's the Baja Marimba Band, okay. There you go, Baja Marimba Band. Right there you go. Blue Hawaii, Billy Vaughn. Was to surprise you. He can surprise you now and then with his, there you go, okay. This is Lost, this is classic, something, it's Flamencio, I enjoy Flamencio, did I pronounce that right, I don't know, anyway, I'll enjoy this one too. This looks good. Pianist, Latin flavored, four Latin flavor. There's four tracks on it. Ritual Fire Dance. I don't know, but that looks really interesting. I don't have that one. 101 strings. There you go. Boston Pops. You got to have a 101 strings in there too. This looks really good. Another full sized 12-inch platter from Plymouth. Music to Dream By, right there. Usually, again, I've only seen 10-inch discs from Plymouth. Night at the Copacabana with Tony Martin. Tony Martin, there he is, Tony Martin. That's Dean Martin's brother, isn't it? Do I know what I'm talking about? No, 1956, however, on RCA. It's a fine cover on this Arthur Fiedler. You see, was it above using some kind of crazy cheesecakey thing to sell records? That Arthur Fiedler. Kiss Me Kate, Hallmark of Fame presents Kiss Me Kate. Right there, all right. It's Martin and Primo. South Pacific. It's a it's a. There we go. Okay. Webley Edwards. Oh, this is a Webley Edwards. Edwards. I don't have. I haven't seen. His famous Hawaii Calls, a radio show from Hawaii, made a lot of records. I don't have this one, and that's a fine cover on that. Webley Edwards presents Fabulous Hawaiian Favorites, Leroy Holmes and Southwind. 50, there can't be. There's 50, it's broken. They're medleys of Hawaiian songs. 50 songs blended into medleys done by Leroy Holmes and the Southwind. Leroy Holmes, oh my God. And the last on the stack is like, where did this come from? Peter Frampton and the Bee Gees. Aerosmith, Alex Cooper. Motion picture soundtrack of what? Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. Never heard of it. They made a movie? I don't know anything about that. Okay, now let's go on to the other stack of records. That'll be interesting. Here you go, Frank Purcell's. So what I'm going to do is play a sample from that stack. Thank you very much, Chris. I appreciate that thoughtfulness. And there are fun records in here for me to go ahead and listen to, and especially was surprised to find the Yama Sumac, which I hope I pronounced that right. Anyway, that was a special surprise for me to know that your parents were listening to her music, okay, because she's really fabulous. And there's nobody like that. There's never been another one like her anywhere that I know of, being able to sing and doing music like that. I mean, anyway, there you go. Okay, Frank Purcell's French Sax. Oh my God, terrific Cheesecake cover on this Frank Purcell album, French Sax. Yes, indeed. Cooking with Ray. Ray D. Michael at his orchestra. Thank you. Sam Taylor, The Mists of the Orient. I have several Sam Taylor albums. He was a horn player. And then he had, records I had, he liked the choral, like the women singing in the background, which makes the record more interesting for me. And here he is in the Orient doing something. So the whole thing, that's going to be interesting. Here's another terrific Cheesecake cover, In the Mood, featuring Lanny Ross and Vincent Lopez and the Alan Roth Orchestra. Terrific Cheesecake cover on Hollywood. Hollywood produced a lot of great covers. On Liberty, it's Virations, Red Norval, and Hi-Fi. That's a terrific cover. And could be pretty darn interesting to listen to. I think this is a comedy album, but it didn't cost me a whole bunch of money. It's got a great cover on it, so I picked it up. I'll do anything for money. All right. Psychiatric, Nutty Time, My Neighbor's Dance, I'll Do Anything for Money, Don Baker, Bobby Baker, Bobby, they say Don, anyway, I'll Do Anything for Money. Music for Romancing, Cha-Cha's, Rumbas, Mambas, Tango Sambas, another great Cheesecake cover on that record. The Girl from Budapest, it's Erwin Hallettz and his orchestra. Don't have any idea. So I can't read the back because the record's there, so I'm leaving out important information as I hold these up because I'm not able to read the stuff on the back. Play, Emery, play. Emery and his Violin of Love. Hello, my sweet. I'm Emery with my Violin of Love. Touch my Violin of Love. Go ahead, touch it. Okay. That's it. Okay, anyway, stories and whatever. Stay tuned. Now for the musical sample. Is there anything else to say that's funny at the end? There's not. Don't have anything funny. Even your Christmas dress. It's not lunch. It's not lunch. It's paint and dog hair. I said I had lunch on my shirt, but it's not. It's like paint and dog hair. You probably can't see that from all the way over there, but that's what it is. Okay.